Hello everyone, it's Kid A, the introverted reader. Before this video starts, I have a surprise for you. Ta-da! Remember when I said that change was coming? Yes, I got my hair cut. It's all gone. It's so short. This feels so weird. I haven't had it this short since like 2016. I chopped it all off and I'm going to be donating it. So, and I think just in these trying times, having shorter hair might be a little bit easier with my occupation and such. Like, I work in a cafe and it's difficult for me to, it's difficult for me to manage my hair when I'm in work. So that's the surprise. Are you over it? okay. This video, as you see by the title, is a book on haul. I am not 100% sure when I'm going to be able to physically move all of these books out of my house because a lot of charity shops and stuff are not accepting books at the moment. I normally would either give them to my library or to a used bookshop, that is nearby me, but I'm not sure if my library is open. I will have to look into that, and the used bookshop hasn't been open in months. But yeah, I just wanted to show you these anyway, just to let you know that these are some, what is that on my shirt? Ew. These are ones I'm gonna be getting rid of. The first two, I read this one years ago and I bought this one when it came out, but if you've been following the internet as of lately, this particular individual has just been going through some things have come out about him. I've been following his content for years, and yes, I noticed the content of his videos. But to be honest, there was some stuff that just came out that I didn't know about, even as a longtime subscriber. And to be honest, I don't really want his books in my house anymore. So yeah, we're gonna be getting rid of those. Don't know when, but I'm just gonna put them to one side for now, take them off the shelf, put them somewhere, and that'll be the end of that. Anyway, the next one that I just wanna get rid of, just for no reason other than I don't have no plans to reread it, is History Is All You Left Me by Adam Silvera. Again, nothing wrong with this book. It is a beautiful story. But if I'm being honest, like I said, I would have no reason to keep it. I would not read it over and over and over again. It's not a favorite. It could be somebody else's favorite. So hopefully whenever the libraries and stuff open up again, I can give it to them or give it to someone who really just wants to read it. The next one that I want to get rid of is Red Sister by Mark Lawrence. I haven't read this. I know what it's about because it's made its rounds around BookTube over the years when it came out. But I've heard just some things about the author. He said apparently some pretty misogynistic and just horrible things just on social media and stuff. And I just don't want that. I don't want that in my life, on my bookshelf. And if I do get the urge to read this, I'll just get it on my Kindle. I won't keep the physical copy. So the next two are part of a series that we were promised a sequel for, or that we were told we were getting a sequel for, but it never happened. And that's of Spirit of Thieves and The Darkest Magic by Morgan Rhodes. Now, I adore the Fallen Kingdom series. I love and adore them. This is supposed to be a spin-off of the Fallen Kingdom series, partly set in modern day Canada and then set in the fantasy world of the Fallen Kingdoms. But yeah, we got this one, and then we got the second one. And yeah, there was a third one up for pre-order. I never pre-ordered it because they only had it in hardcover and I wanted it in the floppy paperback to match the other ones. But the sequel's just not happening anymore, and this series wasn't all that good anyway. I'll still keep hold of my Fallen Kingdoms books because I did love that series, and I'll hopefully reread that soon. But yeah, I'm just gonna get rid of these because what's the point in holding on to a series that is incomplete? The next three books I want to unhaul is the Scythe series by Neil Schusterman. Again, I realize these are popular, they just are not for me. I did enjoy Scythe. Thunderhead was really good, but this one, the third one, was just such a letdown in my opinion. It did not need to be as thick as this. I genuinely feel it did not need to be as thick as this. Hardly anything was happening, nothing was happening, and I didn't care about any of the characters. In the end, I got maybe about halfway through and I was just like, I just don't care anymore. So I didn't even finish it, but yeah, this series is just personally not for me. And if it's your favorite series, then you hold on to it and you love it and you reread it to your heart's content, my love. But just personally for me, it did not hit the mark. So that will be going. The next one I'm gonna get rid of is book one in a trilogy. That's The Magician's Guild by Trudy Canavan. Again, I just didn't overly care. There just wasn't that much happening. I found it kind of boring, if I'm being honest. I didn't really feel anything for any of the characters. I was just reading it to see what would happen next. And I know that's usually what we do when we're reading, but like, I felt it more like an obligation to find out what was gonna happen next. Cause you know, I was just like, it's the first one in a series, it might pick up. But I got less than 100 pages away from the end and still nothing was happening. And I was just like, I'm just not interested anymore. The next one I'm getting rid of is, again, another one in a series, and there's nothing particularly wrong with it. I just don't feel like keeping it. And once the sequel comes out, I'll just get it onto my Kindle, and that's The Guinevere Deception by Kirsten White. Again, an enjoyable first book, but I think I only gave, majority of all of these, I think I only gave like 3 stars or something. And see, to be honest, if I have anything on my shelf that's 3 stars or below, I don't feel like keeping it. Yeah, I just wasn't feeling this. I mean, I guess it was okay, but yeah, I just wasn't wowed by it. And I want books on my shelf that I can look at and be like, wow, I love that. Like, I just don't want any negativity on my bookshelf right now. And just looking at any of these, yeah, just, I don't know. I'll get the sequel when it comes out, but I just want to be rid of this physical copy because I'm not going to get the physical copies of the other two. The next one that I'm going to be getting rid of is American Royals by Catherine McGee. This was our book club pick a couple months ago. Again, it was okay. It's an interesting concept. It's basically set in a world where if America had a royal family as opposed to an elected body with a president. And that, again, interesting concept, like good in theory, execution not so much. yeah, to be honest, I thought the characters were kind of bland. The drama that was in here was just put in there for drama's sake, in my opinion. One of them fell in love with her bodyguard, and I didn't feel anything for either of them. I didn't care about either one of them. And yeah, again, like the villain in here, like she was literally just there to be the mean girl and to have blonde hair and sharp nails and be all like, I'm gonna get you all. And it's like, I'm not here for that. I'm not here for that at all. So yeah, it's gonna go. The next one that's gonna go should be of no surprise to anyone. Leon the Offbeat by Becky Arbatelli. I adore Simon vs. the Homo Sapiens Agenda. I do. It's right up there on the favorite shelf. Simon will always have a special place in my heart, but he was the only good thing about this book. Leah is terrible. I don't like her at all. I was not feeling the romance, and to be honest, all the characters were just bland in my opinion. Yeah, I didn't really like any of them, especially Leah. I just wanted to slap her across the face. So yeah, honest opinion right there. The very, very last one that I'll be getting rid of is My Brother's Name is Jessica by John Boyne. I read this during Pride Month. If you watch my June wrap up, I go a little bit more in depth as to why I want to get rid of this. It just made me feel kind of uncomfortable. I'm not all that great with the title. Just the themes in here, just all the transphobia and like just the homophobia and everything. Like they were making The Purge, like Jessica, the trans girl who's going through this change. They just made her feel like crap all the time. They were making her feel like she was committing this horrendous crime against her family, and, you know, oh, woe is me, oh man. It's just like, I just don't want that in my life, okay? I didn't even rate it on Goodreads. I just felt that uncomfortable, and I don't want this in my house or in my life. So, those are all the books that I will be hopefully getting rid of soon. Obviously, like I said, I can't physically move them from my house at the moment. Hopefully, the libraries and such will be opening up again soon. I need to double check to see whether or not my local library is open and if they are accepting donations. If they are, then I'll try and give some of these away. Again, apologies if I mentioned your favorite book. It's nothing against you. It's nothing personal. It's just books, people, okay? So yeah, let me know if you've read any of these and whether you like them or whether you feel the same as me or if you got rid of them or what. What are some books that you've gotten rid of? I hope you're staying safe and staying sane. And remember, don't be messy, don't be racist, and wash your hands, you sinners. Bye-bye.